Right. Well, firstly, I think that earnings really is going to be the pivotal key for markets as we look forward. Right now, we're at a really an inflection point for stocks. And I think stocks are waiting to see how much has the bite from higher energy, higher, you know, food cost inflation really hit the bottom line, as well as how companies are managing to deal through this, you know, sort of conflict and you know, much more challenging operating environment in terms of demand and whether there's been any signs of demand destruction thus far. So I think what you want to focus on right now is first companies that are not big, that don't have commodities and food costs as big inputs into their costs. And secondly, being really focused on which can continue to drive demand in a difficult environment. And so I'm focused on companies that have high free cash flow growth, really solid balance sheets, are a little bit more defensive in nature, and are not as cyclical. And I think large cap tech does really well as a screen, as well as the healthcare sector, which has really been forgotten about for, you know, several quarters. And I think you'll start to see that really shine and outperform as we move through the rest of this year, particularly into first quarter earnings season. The other, you know, sort of angle that I continue to want to own in my portfolio is commodity exposure. So being long, you know, commodity inputters. So, you know, examples of that are energy, and MLPs, energy, as well as copper names as well, that I think will really stand to benefit from continued appreciation of the underlying commodity.
So large cap tech, healthcare, and energy. Got it. The only question I would have, Aaron, is this a market that is going to be driven by earnings? I look at what happened with Levi's today. They put up really good numbers and did not change guidance. They reaffirmed it despite the worsening inflation picture and all of the headwinds on the supply chain. I just heard from him, no slowdown in consumer demand in the U.S. and not even in Europe. And yet the stock is lower because macro headlines and concerns about economic slowdown. So is that just going to be pervasive despite what we hear from the companies, which so far you haven't heard a lot of slowdown type commentary from companies?
I think that's right, but I think the market is also discounting what the forward estimates are and projections are of corporate managers, because in the past we found that a lot of times companies are the last to be able to see, you know, the writing on the walls. And so I think for certain sectors where you have, where everyone knows that there's really high input costs and that they're going to hit and that they're exposed to the consumer, which is waning, particularly on the low end side, I think the market is going to allow the macro to drive the narrative as opposed to corporates driving that narrative. But I do think that earnings will be important, particularly for differentiation, and particularly as we start to see more names and more companies report and we get a broader macro narrative being driven by corporates as opposed to one-offs.